Hi, my name is Tim Anger, and I'm on the FHAA Board of Directors, and I'm also a longtime evaluator with the FHAA program, close to 30 years now. And just this past summer, I had a mom who has a ninth grade daughter mention to me that she was a little confused on how to register for the FHAA program so that her daughter could start, earning the credits and all. And she asked, when do I have to? Did I miss the deadline? Did I have to be registered before ninth grade? So I just want to take a couple minutes and answer that question and kind of show you the website and some of the forms that you need to use. So first off, it's highly recommended that a student join during their ninth grade year because there are a lot of benefits. And there's another video that Mrs. Richmond has done, kind of explains those benefits. I would say if you're not certain which diploma program you want to go with, or if you want to do the parent issued option, that try to meet the requirements of the FHAA program for ninth grade and 10th grade. And if you're doing fine so far, then at the end of 10th grade, definitely get registered so that you have your student number. Your evaluator at the end of 10th grade and during 11th grade will need that number in order to upload your evaluation letters and start working on your transcript. That's the only way as evaluators that we can do that is if we have a number. So, here's what the website looks like, and I'll just point out here that it says Guide to the Homeschool Diploma, Pennsylvania Homeschool Diploma, and this tab here shows what that looks like. It's used to be a printed book, and you had to pay to have that mailed to you, and now it's available for free on the website. A lot of information in there. It's like an ebook, okay? And so that's one resource that we make available. A little further down on this homepage, this is actually the page under forms, okay? And it says click here to download the filing form, which is used to open a file for your homeschooled student when you join the FHAA program. All right, so that's what this form looks like, and I have a copy right here. It's just called a student filing form, and check off whatever is appropriate here, and your student's name, their signature, date of birth, all of this sort of thing, okay? And then it tells you exactly where to mail the form, and there needs to be a check accompanying this. If for some reason you are one of the millennial parents who no longer have checks with your bank account, you can actually call Dr. Richmond and pay via PayPal, all right? So they do accept PayPal and credit cards through PayPal. So if you need to do that, you can contact them, but it's easier if you just mail in the form with a printed check. And it tells you the cost on here. There's a $45 filing fee, and that's only once, okay? It's not every year. It's just once to join the program. And then there's one other form that I want to point out, and that is the year's work checklist. And you should kind of keep track while you're going through. This is also in the guide if you want to print out the guide. But these are the courses that a student needs to be completing each year. And just to make sure you're on track, and you can give this to your evaluator to show that you have met the requirements of the program each year. Your evaluator will work on a transcript, okay? And so this is for a student who finished his junior year, has one more year to go. So all the courses are organized by year on the transcript and by subject this direction. And if they've taken a college course, kind of like a dual enrollment, then it'll indicate that down here. It already has the evaluator's signature on there. And then as a parent, you would sign these three places and eventually a fourth place, and then there would be a fifth spot for parents of seniors to sign. And then the last thing I want to point out, and this is there's two other forms you can download, and one is called the diploma request, and that you would do at the end of 12th grade, and that's a very nice padded diploma. It has your student's name on there, your evaluator's signature, Dr. Richmond's signature, and then as a parent, you should sign that as well. And then it says click here to download the transcript request form. And that's when your student has enrolled at a college and they are requesting an official transcript. And then that formal, and there's a small fee that goes with that, and then there's a whole packet of papers that either can be emailed via PDF or can be mailed to the college for your students and for their college records. So that's one of the great services. And sometimes, you know, 10, 15, 20 years later, students are changing job or trying to get a job with the government, and they need proof of their high school graduation from the issuing organization. And so FAA is able to turn around and issue those transcripts and diplomas if needed. So it's a great service, and it's a very small fee, but I hope that helps you know what you need to do. So the first step is really just get the filing form. That's the main thing. There's very little to fill out on here, and get that in the mail with a check. All right, and then your main contact is your evaluator, and the FAA evaluators are very knowledgeable. They can get answers for you. And then if there are questions, Dr. and Mrs. Richmond or board members are available as well for you to just pick up the phone or send an email and get your questions answered. So welcome to the program. I think it'll be a great benefit to your teen, and prepare them well for college. Thanks.